Very good evening to all the viewers, learners, teachers, educators, students to CIT NCERT's live phone-in program. And this is panel discussion on cyber safety. NCERT in collaboration with CDAC Hyderabad organized a series of webinars from February 1st to 8th. And today we are having a panel discussion to unfold the relevance of cyber city and security in school education. And the guests who have joined us today for this panel discussion, I would like to introduce Srimati P.R. Lakshmi Isavari, Director, CDAC Hyderabad. And Professor Amrendra P. Behra will also be joining us today for this discussion, Joint Director, CIT and CRT. Shri C.H.A.S. Murthy, Associate Director, CDAC Hyderabad, and National Coordinator, ISEAPMU, has also joined us today for this discussion. We welcome you. And Professor Indu Kumar, Head DICT and TD CIT NCERT, is there with us in studio. We welcome you as well, Madam.
Thank you.
And before we start with today's panel discussion on Safe Internet Day, I would like to remind you here that in between this panel discussion, if you have any questions, any queries, any suggestions, then do let us know. Dial on our toll-free numbers. Numbers would be 1-800-111-265 and the other number is 1-800-112-199. To watch the live streaming of this program, kindly log into our official YouTube channel, NCERT Official, and there also in the live chat box, you can send all your suggestions and questions. Certainly, we will be taking up all of them in the last segment of this discussion. And there is one more medium on which you can contact us. You can also mail your questions on trainings@ciet.nic.in. So today is globally, we celebrate Safer Internet Day. And on every Tuesday of February. So keeping that in mind, NCERT has arranged this panel discussion. And for this panel discussion, firstly, I would like to invite Srimati P.R. Lakshmi Isavari ji for this discussion. And she will be telling us about the importance of emerging technologies for cybersecurity. I welcome you again, Ms. Lakshmi, on PME Vidya.
Very thank you. Yeah.
So first of all, discussion.
Yeah. So first of all, I thank NCERT for associating with CDAC in arranging the web series on cybersecurity and safety, and also making us part of this particular panel discussion. So I was asked to talk about the emerging technologies, but let me tell some background about the evolution of networks and the kind of threat has evolved over the period. So if you analyze carefully at the minute level, we are very clear that, we started using the desktop computers some 10 years back. So, and then we slightly moved to the laptops and then moved to the smartphones. So, and if you analyze, actually, we used to have the wired network. That's how we used to connect to the internet and gradually move to the wireless. So anywhere, anytime from our the computing device, we are able to connect and try to access the internet and cyber part. So if you look at it at the simple way, the way we are trying to access these kind of services, if for carrying out our online shopping or online banking or any kind of learning, so we used to depend on these kind of online services. So, but if you analyze actually like in the last 1 year, so with the pandemic situation, we learned a lesson that without going to the schools or any kind of thing, without having the movement, physical movement, but still we could continue all our activities with the cyber world. So the way the people also who never used these online tools, even online video conferencing tools and other things. So overnight they had to learn all these kind of things and then carry out their actions. You look at the teachers, they learned and they started delivering the classes, the parents, educated parents, uneducated parents, anyone you talk about, because they have to adapt to the situation. And students, if you ask them, they'll come to know so many options about using this kind of tools and all. So this is a way, sitting in the drawing room or something like that. So teachers started delivering the classes and students started listening to the classes. So that's how we could continue our education system and then have the learning experience, even in spite of having this kind of pandemic where everything got locked down. So this is a kind of convenience we got from the technologies. So if you look at the evolution, as I was mentioning, we moved from the desktop world with the wired networks, and then we moved to the laptops, and then the iPads and other kind of things, and the smartphones. So with the wireless, okay, so a lot of convenience has come to us over the period, and within no time, we are trying to install the apps from the Google Play Store and other Play Stores, and then started carrying out our activity. So if you analyze XBC, technology has brought a lot of convenience to all of us, but at the same time, the same technology also creates a lot of threats to us. So if we try to analyze at the minute level, see, ultimately, whatever we do in the digital world, we want to carry out our activities in the legitimate fashion or expected behavior. Suppose if I do some kind of online banking, there is expected behavior I am looking at. So I need to complete my banking transactions without any problem and other things like that. Similarly, whenever I attend an online class, I need to have some kind of facility trying to carry out that. But the same technology, we also looked at by the adversary, some kind of damage or kind of unsafe things to the individual. So that is something crucial. So sometimes our PIN details stolen or passwords may be stolen, some things like that. So social media networks and other. So we try to make friends with someone because we are not seeing anyone. So we assume that something which is not seen may not be a threat to us. But that is not true in the digital world. So there is a lot of threat and unsafe kind of things happening. So if you analyze like that, the same technology has brought in a lot of the threat to us, and it is our responsibility to understand the technologies at the same time, how to protect and how to make ourselves comfortable and safe in accessing this particular cyber world. So we talk about so many things like Internet of the IoT, Internet of Things, blockchain technology, artificial intelligence. So like that, so many things on wireless 5G networks and other things. All these things are trying to do a lot of convenience to the end user, and they carry out the activities very efficiently. We build a lot of intelligence and other things. But at the same time, the same intelligence can be utilized in order to carry out some kind of the fraudulent things by the adversary. So cyber crime can be detected with the intelligence, artificial intelligence. At the same time, the cyber crimes also may be conducted by using this kind of technology. So we need to be very careful, especially when we talk about the teacher community and all. What my sincere request is, whenever you make a student learn this technology, you tell them to understand all the options in securing that, how effectively you can secure the browser and online tools and other things, all those privacy aspects and other things. We need to teach them. Along with the student, we need to tell the parents also, because they are the people, parents who are supporting the students at their home. We need to generate awareness even for the parents. So technology is double-edged, both it gives benefits, at the same time it will also try to give the threat. So it is our responsibility to understand on the threat side, and then try to effectively utilize the technology to safely make use of this particular cyber world. So these are some comments about the emerging technologies and what kind of care we need to take.
Absolutely, and indeed, well said that in this pandemic, the kind of exposure we have got and the kind of revolution, I would say, this digital mediums have given to the education is new for us, and we have to really keep a check on cyber safety. And in sequence to this, next I would invite Sri A.S. Murthy, Associate Director, CDAC Hyderabad. I welcome you again, Mr. Murthy. And I would like you to elaborate something on importance of cybersecurity in digital world for our viewers.
Yeah, is it audible?
Yes, you're audible.
Yeah, when we are considering this cybersecurity, so cybersecurity is one of the important for everybody, including whether it is you consider as in a person or as a considered as an organization. Which is very important because it encompasses everything that pertains to protecting our sensitive data, like personally identifiable information, personal information, intellectual property, data. So whatever you take from your side, the cybersecurity is very important. Whenever I go anywhere, I generally interact with the people, even the workshops also. What is exactly the difference between cybersecurity and cyber safety? This is what my first question of any workshop. See, because we need to understand clarity, within a clarity, about the cyber security. The cyber security is majorly we look about that protecting our data, protecting our information, whether it could be a personal information or official information. We need to be a part of looking about that their security of these whatever the information products, even you wanted to do that. So that's what nowadays every organization looking about majorly to protect their intellectual property, data, and even that industry information systems related to that. This cybersecurity can be defined into a number of ways. Even the further you can define into the number of segments like physical security, communication security. But however, so this is all comes under part of the information. So information is very much important, because while you are giving your information, then only there could be possible threat on you or on your organization. See, because you just look about, we are not nowadays looking about only that firewalls, antivirus software, and all are gone those days, because they are the products to secure our information, to secure our assets in organization or in our home. But however, now target is going to each and every person, whether it is yesterday only we have looked about there are 34,000 rupees fraud with Delhi CM's daughter. So for attacking any individual person, there is no difference for whether you are daughter of CM or even if you are having 500 rupees with you in your account, like your digital account of your mobile, I am ready to take it out as an attacker. So the main motto is that get the information, a particular person, whatever the things are there. So whether it could be a data, you do the breach of the data, or whether it could be at the matter of money, the steal the money. This is what happening, so that everybody should have take their own responsibility to be part of the cyber safety. Because why I'm saying cyber safety? When you are looking about protecting your individual information as in a human being, which we called it as in a cyber safety. When we are looking about the assets of us and protecting the assets, we are considering as in a cyber security. This is what the is a kind of thin line between the cyber security and cyber safety. But as individual, when you are taking this, that definitely you should be a responsible for as being when you are playing two roles. So as in a teacher or as in a home or a homemaker or anybody. So every human being is generally plays two roles. One is official role, one is at a family role. So both sides we need to take understanding about the whatever the activities, what kind of possible threats, and we should have some kind of risk assessment. So with respect to your individual perspective and your official duty perspective, so that if you can define these things, so basically you can protect yourself. Of course, the tools definitely if you consider as part of the cybersecurity, if you are using your antivirus, but I'm always stress that updated antivirus, because we use it to get more than 6,000 different kinds of malwares in the world. And every day, so maybe you are not part of each and every malware, but some of the malwares may affect your products, so that you need to update and you have to clean them with your updated antivirus. Second is operating system. Let's say take example of your operating system. Operating system is like you can consider it is our body. Suppose let's say if you are getting like a fever maybe could be a reason, a seasonal fever, but this fever is continuously coming. So then what is that? Definitely you have some kind of problem in your body. So that if it is a fever, you can take it medicine like an antivirus. But if it is a long-term problem is there in your body, you need to operate it. So that is where we always stress that operating system updates. Also very much important along with that your antivirus or information security software. Then third one, use one desktop firewall where you can control your communication. It is very important that the individual should have some kind of a control on the data sharing. So whether it could be controlling your data from your computer, whether it could be a control of your personal information like passwords, OTPs, also is very important. This firewall, whether it is physical on your computers or logical in your mind, you should not share any kind of information to anybody, like the social media and other kind of networks. You cannot share, even though whether it is required or not required. So every time, whenever you are sharing something, you should think of that, what purpose you are sharing or for whom you are sharing. Is it the right to share? So these three things, if you are remembering, it is work like a human firewall for you if you are considering these three things. So definitely you can control the information. So these three principles for anybody can give a kind of a shape while accessing the your internet. So these cyber threats can come from any level of person. It's not like any one particular person is target or a particular group of people is target. Everybody is targeted, whether you have a 500 rupees, whether you have a 1 lakh rupee, whether you have a thousands of lakhs of rupees. The cyber attack can happen anybody. So it's everybody's responsibility to consider and to support the cyber safety activities to make our society as much as safe.
Right. So these were the details given by our expert, and indeed we have to keep in mind while using internet what all Mr. Murthy just discussed. Now, coming on to Professor Indu Kumar, I welcome you again for this discussion. And if you could tell our viewers something about the cyber safety in relevance to parents, teachers and students.
Yeah. So, given the current pandemic situation, when the entire education system has to switch over to the online mode,
digital mode
using internet, right, it is very, very important that safety and security concerns need to be taken care
of. Absolutely.
So, as in the physical world, when we move in the physical world, so many do's and don'ts are told to us. Don't speak to the strangers. Come home after a certain period of time or certain hours of the day. Don't stay outside late at night. So all such do's and don'ts we follow, and we also make our children follow. But when it comes to moving in the cyber world, sometimes we miss these do's and don'ts. Because of the lack of awareness, because we are new to the use of internet and switching over to the
education,
with the gadgets. So now teachers and students, they are using gadget to interact with each other. So in the given scenario, it is very, very important for a teacher to know the rules of cyber safety and security. It is also very, very important for the students to know these rules and regulations of using internet or moving in the cyber world, and it is equally important for the parents also to understand the rules and regulations while they are in the cyber world and their children are moving in the cyber world. So there are some aspects of the cyber safety and security when it is dealing with the world or moving in the cyber world. So there are technical aspects to cyber safety and security. There are ethical aspects. There are legal aspects. And there are also some social aspects to cyber safety and security. And apart from this, we need to take care of our wellness also while we are using gadgets and we are moving in the cyber world. So all these things need to be taken care of. Some things are common for all these stakeholders, teachers, students, and parents. But there are certain specific things which a teacher or a parent or a student need to take care of while using devices or while moving in the cyber world. When it comes to technical aspects to cyber safety and security, we need to keep our devices protected.
Okay.
So we need to, some of the aspects are covered by the previous speaker, like we have to protect our devices by using
antivirus.
So we have to have a strong password so that our devices are not misused. And we have to keep, when it comes to a school, we have to keep the digital environment of the school protected. And we need to orient the teachers to it, and we also need to orient the students while using this digital environment, what do's and don'ts they need to follow. So a lot of activity, being a teacher, students and parent, we do. We shop. We are there on social media interacting right. with people. Sometimes we are interacting with strangers
as well.
And we are sharing our crucial information with these strangers. We get friendly with these strangers on internet, which right. we don't do in the physical world because we think that we are not in a face-to-face situation. But gradually, we tend to share our important information with these strangers. And in any manner, these informations are misused by those strangers. So there is a concept of grooming also. Like adult, they groom children in a way, young children in a way, that they follow whatever instructions they are giving. And sometimes they trap them into doing some unethical
right.
Behavior because they are young children. They just motivate them to use some inappropriate images
yeah.
of theirs or video of theirs.
There have been several cases, Professor.
Yeah. cases also, like
right.
Boys' locker room incident recently
yeah,
happened.
Yeah.
And I was listening to a news today morning that
yeah.
Daughter of a very important political personality was
yeah.
shopping, and a QR code was shared with her. And
okay.
Her money was transferred to the person who shared that QR code. As soon as she scanned that QR code, 36,000 of her money was just trapped out
just
of her,
yeah,
transferred from her account to someone
else.
Stranger. So now we are also, during the pandemic, we are moving to internet shopping. So a lot of such financial crimes are also
right.
happening. So students are doing a lot of shopping online and they are losing money, their hard-earned money of themselves or their parents. So all such incidents are there. So we need to take care of all these aspects.
Absolutely.
And when it comes to ethical aspects of it, we have to respect the privacy of other people's also. Like many incidents are coming when people start trolling each other on
yeah.
internet. So such trolling should also not be there. So these ethical aspects, and when we are in the face-to-face situation, we adopt and follow certain etiquettes. But when we are on the internet, they are netiquettes also. So we need to follow those netiquettes.
Okay.
To take care of, to respect other people also,
right.
which sometimes we don't do. Because we are not in a face-to-face situation and we are writing on social media. So bluntly, we just post and write anything. So sometimes it hampers the self-respect of other people. And sometimes it hurts the sentiments of religious, social and other sentiments of the people who are there in the cyber world. So all such things are happening. And when it comes to the social aspects of cyber safety and security, so many times when we are going somewhere, so we post our locations
pictures
also.
Pictures and locations.
So where
yeah.
we are giving.
Heading
sometimes
towards.
It can also pose a threat to us in any manner. So sometimes somebody can chase you if you are
right.
going somewhere because you have shared that important information and you have also, your home is under lock and keys. So somebody, they get this information
right.
because you have shared that you are moving somewhere and you have shared your location. So all such things should not happen. We should take care of all these things. And also intellectual property right we need to take care of if we are teachers, we are parents or we are students.
Yeah.
So other people's information, we should not steal the data created by other people.
That's also
and,
a concern these days, Professor
That
Kumar.
Is also yeah,
yeah.
a very, very important concern because
yeah.
we take data because it's a time of knowledge explosion. a lot of knowledge is there on the internet. But if we use the copyrighted material, it is unethical. We should not use other people's material, or we should give a proper credit also to the people.
Right.
So there are sites where the content is shared with some liberal licensing.
Right.
So we have to look for such websites where such contents are shared if we want to use them for educational purpose, but we need to give credit to the creator of those content. So all this, these aspects we need to take care of. And one more thing is there, we need to take care of some certain ergonomics also. So how we are sitting when we are in front, because we are spending lot of hours in front of our devices. So we have to adopt right postures also, so that we don't get into any kind of ailment or physical.
So with these concerns, whatever we have discussed, health is also a major
health
concern.
Is also very, very important, and it is physical as well as mental health.
Absolutely.
While using devices and while being on in the cyber world.
Right. So in 24 hours maximum time, like not just the students or maybe teachers or all working professionals are spending in front of the screens. So these have to be also taken care of.
So because we are our eyesight is also compromised.
Right.
So we need to take care how much screen time. Parents need to manage the screen time of their children. How much time they are spending on their screen. So there are now inbuilt mechanism in the device. You can check your screen time. So how much time you have spent on your mobile screen.
In all smartphones, we have that
we
feature
have
of
that
keeping
feature.
A track of screen time.
So we can monitor our screen time, or parent can monitor screen time of their children by looking at their devices.
And before pointing out to our youngsters, we also have to keep a check on our screen times and the kind of social media exposure or gadget exposure we are having.
If parents are preaching their children to do certain things and not to do certain things,
first
they
have to follow.
They have to follow all those rules for themselves also.
Right, absolutely.
So these are some of the aspects. If you want to ask any questions related to
it, certainly we will be. And the official YouTube streaming of this program is happening on our official YouTube channel, NCRT Official. Viewers, please send your questions. I can see many viewers are watching us live, so we can discuss question answer some questions with our experts today. And we shall take some questions which are sent by our viewers. And here I would like to invite. First, I will ask the questions to Mrs. Lakshmi. Am I audible to you, madam?
Yes, very much.
So, there's one very important and relevant question, I would say, Lakshmi ji, here. These days, whenever we are traveling or we are in a... any social platform, we tend to get this public Wi-Fi. So is it really safe at times to connect our gadgets to public Wi-Fi? What would you say about this?
See, actually, like when you connect to the public Wi-Fi, there are a few things which we need to be very careful, like especially, like security aspects of the Wi-Fi hotspot is also very, very important. Okay. See, what happens is, like, if it is not properly secured or if you are not accessing through some password enabled channel, then definitely a lot of malware and all might be penetrating into that particular thing, through which it can try to steal your sensitive information also. So anything which is protected, the device is protected, hotspot is protected, and in a secure manner, if you are trying to access through your mobile number, if they are trying to send you some kind of PIN number through which you are trying to access and other things, the secure way of accessing is definitely the better option. But without security, if you are trying to access such kind of hotspots are enabled, definitely with the same easiness, even adversary also can try to access them. And the penetration also can happen to the hotspot, and then through that, attacks can be launched. So we need to be very, very careful in using the secure devices through which you can try to access them. The Wi-Fi and the free internet services wherever they are available.
So these were the points you have to keep in mind while connecting to free Wi-Fi. We really thank you, Srimati P.R. Lakshmi, for answering this question sent by one of our viewer. And in sequence to this, we are leading towards the last segment of this program. And here now we are joined by Professor Amrendra Behra, Joint Director CIT and CRT. I welcome you, Professor Behra, for this
Namaskar.
Panel discussion.
Very good afternoon to all of you.
Yeah, good evening.
And wish all of you a safe internet day as well.
Absolutely. And we have almost discussed all the aspects. And here I would like you to throw some light, as in this pandemic, we have got a vast exposure to, I would say, revolutionary exposure to education. So in terms of cyber safety, what are the measures we have to keep in mind in school system? If you could please throw some light.
Thank you very much, Kriti. Once again, happy Internet Cyber Safety Day. And be safe and stay safe at home and learn. And all of us, we know that the COVID pandemic has already taught us how to use ICT, and it is a new normal as well. And since March, our teachers across the country, nearly 15 lakh teachers and nearly 26 crore school students, and even in higher education also, people are using ICT in a big way and using online learning. Keeping in view this particular situation, NCERT has developed a series of cyber safety and security guidelines. In collaboration with CIDAC, and two of our colleagues are from CIDAC, I thank them for being with us, and also in collaboration with UNESCO Delhi office, and a couple of cyber safety security guidelines have been developed, and also NCERT has come out with one Pragyata guideline for digital education, keeping
right.
in view the RAS of digital education in this situation, it has been developed. So it has also elaborated the academic steps, particularly the instructional steps, how to use particularly ICT in teaching learning process. And also there are tips for being safe in internet, and given for parents, for school students, for teachers, teacher educators, and schools as a whole also. And not only that, because physical health and well-being is also another concern while using cyberspace. So how we can be safe, healthy also, and the ergonomics, particularly the body posture and all, we have to maintain, that also has been suggested. But all of us, we know that if the tips, we consider the cyber safety tips, so prevention is better than cure.
Right.
So, because we need to prevent ourselves from any cyber safety security attacks,
yeah.
and keep our password and ID intact, and also see that if any particularly mischiefs happening in our portal and app,
yeah.
so that we act promptly. So these are some of the things we need to take care of, so that we are safe on cyber world, and also attend to online classes in an uninterrupted manner. So with these words, I once again congratulate all the 85 lakh teachers in school sector, and also all the students, those who are using online learning, and the parents who are guiding their kids in this cyber world, because many times students are using the gadgets of their parents or their elder siblings. So in that case, we need to keep students safe in cyber world and learn as well. So best wishes from NCERT and my personal behalf on Safe Internet Day.
Absolutely. And here many viewers are watching us live on official YouTube streaming, and we have been getting questions. And Professor Kumar, here I would like to ask you, as we just discussed about the kind of violence also happening on social media, so women are, you know, they are often subject to such violence, cyber violence, I would say. So what are the measures we have, which have to be taken care of or have to be campaigned to hold raising awareness for women's safety in cyber world? If you could elaborate something.
So that that is very, very important aspect.
Yeah.
If any kind of violence is going on in the cyber world, so generally women are more vulnerable to it because we are not we are not used to seeing women so outgoing on internet.
Right.
So generally, then we think that they are these girls are easily available to us. So keeping that mindset in mind, sometimes we try to approach those women or ladies in an inappropriate manner.
Yeah.
So to prevent this, we need to take care of that. Whatever we are sharing on internet, we have to be very, very careful about it. We should not share our personal information, our pictures which are not worth using on internet, so that we are not trolled by the people. And not only women, our children are also vulnerable to some many kind of emotional and social and other kind of violence on internet. So if we understand what we need to do and what we need not to do on internet, if we take care of the ethical aspect to internet, then we can keep ourselves safe. Anyone cannot speak to a stranger on internet. We should not get friendly to the people whom we don't know by the connection of any of our acquaintances, or we don't personally know them. We should not get into any relationship with them. So if we take care of all these things, so we can keep ourselves protected. But if any kind of violence is committed to you, so we should not get afraid. We have to report it.
Right.
First of all, we have to report it. If we are children or young women, we need to report it to some elderly people. So not discussing is not a solution to any problem. So we need to discuss it. And parents, I want to give tips to parents also. Parents need to have such kind of a bond with their children that they share anything with their parent, so that relationship of trust encourage children to share anything with their parent, and they can keep themselves protected by doing that. And in some many cities there are some toll-free numbers also, because when some kind of crime is committed to a woman, keeping in view the socialization or the social stigma related to it, sometimes they don't want to come up public by for reporting such issues. So there are such numbers where they can keep their identity protected, and they can complain on such kind of crimes against them to the police or to the cell which are meant for that. So all such provisions are there, but first of all, we need to be very careful while sharing anything by making our digital image on internet. So we need
digital
to
image.
Have a
of course.
Digital image also.
And you just said that this dialogue between parents and students, because these youngsters getting exposure to these gadgets, so it is really important. And indeed, sharing is caring. Parents and teachers have to keep a check on what sort of exposure social media also is giving to our youngsters. And here, you just use the word digital self-image. So, Professor Behra, I would like you to throw some light on this itself, that what it is about, digital self-image.
Actually, Kriti, rightly we are discussing that because all of us, we are present in the digital world. So whether it is social media, through our Facebook account, through Twitter handle, or through even
Instagram
WhatsApp. So there are many social, even LinkedIn. So many such activities we are doing. And we it also depend that how we are behaving there, because always I cannot say that my friends or my virtual friends, they will be doing good. But I should also pose an example for others. So while posting, so I should not have any post related to personal attack, like madam was saying, on cyberbullying. So should not be done. And anybody should not also copy something from somewhere and also share it without the permission, including photographs and all. Many times we don't take consent of any friend and we post their personal event photographs in cyberspace. So we need to be sensitive towards that, because whatever we are doing, it also reflect on the society. So if we are a good user of the cyber world, and we are a sensitized workforce,
individual.
So in that case, it will also reflect on society. So always we should, whether it is on real world or virtual world, we should pose ourselves as a role model, because children are also following us.
Right.
So children learn through thousands of ways. Anukaran or hanukaran, imitation, is also one of the way of learning. So if we share good things and follow best practices, children also follow that. Otherwise, if we do not do that, children also tend to do that. So we have to be very careful on social world and on cyber world.
So this digital self-image has to be taken care of, as Professor Behra just said. And here I would like to ask Shri A.S. Murthy, I would like you to bring it to the discussion again, Mr. Murthy. And generally, we have, if we talk about website and online shopping also, we just discussed. So, how can we judge between a fake website and legitimate websites with regard to online shopping, what all we've discussed in this discussion?
Yeah, this is a typical question. Because, we used to get a lot of URLs, either in the form of messages or either in the form of emails, or somebody forward the message about the various discounts and all. See, when we have seen, if you know that actual URL, uniform resource locator, then you can always type and look about that in the search engine itself directly, whether that offer could be there or not there. So anytime you click the link, that link, whether it is going to the legitimate site or it is going to the some fake website, very difficult for a normal user. So that is why what we suggest, that such the offers, if you get it, so simply copy, you don't, without clicking, better you go to search engine, or otherwise you go to that legitimate website. Let's say, take example, it would be a Amazon.in or Flipkart.in. So you just go to that website and search such kind of pages rather than clicking. So the second thing you need to consider, whether that that particular URL is HTTPS or not. But however, nowadays fake websites are also coming as part of, as look like an HTTPS websites. Along with that HTTP website, you require padlock, and you require to see padlock, and you require to see certificate, which is very difficult for the normal users. So always, so we say that whenever you get a link, you just copy and paste and see that in another tab or another browser. So that would be the choice. But there is no guarantee that you will go to the legitimate site. You need to find that various resources, like you search it and you do the English. And only we suggest that go to the trusted website. Like I can trust Microsoft.com, trust ncrt.org.in. So like that, wherever the trusted websites are there, you just type of these trusted sites in the URL rather than clicking the links. So then only you can avoid it. And most of these websites are also coming with the padlock and HTTPS, so that you may please be careful while you are clicking these links. Never click the link. So always copy and paste it and look about that HTTPS padlock.
Mr. Murthy, here I would like you to launch the quiz which we were discussing about the series of webinars we've had. So if you could launch the quiz for our viewers, please. And in accordance to the webinars we've had about cyber safety from 1st to 8th February, we have a quiz which has to be launched. And I request again Shri Murthyji to please launch the quiz for our viewers.
So this is what Safer Internet Quiz as part of that. And this would be open from the today itself. And we end it up to 28th February 2021. And by giving these details, and these details would be kept as much as secured, and we never shared with anything, anybody. So this is only for that, giving the certificate as part of this. So this is what the quiz.
So that was about the quiz our expert just has launched regarding the cyber safety webinars which we conducted. And here I would like to request Professor Behra to kindly launch the course for this particular cyber safety. If you could please
thank
share.
Thank you very much, Kriti. So this is the course. You can see the banner which is visible from here. Personal Digital Devices in collaboration with SIDAC and ISEA. And this course is available on Diksha platform. And we need to, all the teachers and teacher educators and students, they can take up the course, and general publics and parents also can take up the course and get themselves sensitized and be particularly exercise informed choices as far as cyber safety and security are concerned. So this course will be open for all of you. And do join us in this course, and be sensitized on cyber safety and security, and stay safe on the cyber world. Thank you.
Yeah, that was the course, and I would request Professor Kumar to please tell us about the guidelines as well.
So I'm very happy to launch this cyber safety and security guidelines for teachers, students, and parents. So NCERT has already developed these guidelines for students, teachers and schools in English. But the Hindi version of these guidelines we have developed in collaboration with CDAC. And the guidelines for parents in Hindi and English we have developed in collaboration with CDAC. So I am very happy to launch these guidelines. And whatever we have spoken today in a very limited time, the details of all these can be found in these guidelines. So everyone is welcome to access all these guidelines to know more about cyber safety and security for teachers, students, and parents. So
right. So these were the guidelines of the
guidelines
course.
Are, yeah.
And here I would like to tell our viewers that we also have a Telegram channel, the link of which is on your screens. You can also join for this cyber safety and the webinars we have conducted. And it was really a pleasure of having all the guests, and you all have shared such a worthy and valuable information today. We really thank Srimati Lakshmi ji for joining us today. We thank you, Lakshmi ji, for joining today, and we thank Shri A.S. Murthy ji as well, who joined from CDAC. And I really thank Professor Behra, CIT Joint Director, for joining us today for this wonderful discussion, and Professor Kumar also for giving your generous support for this panel discussion.
And I also thank Madam Lakshmi and Mr. Murthy from CDAC for joining with us on behalf of NCERT. And we hope that such collaboration will help all the students and teachers to be sensitized on cyber safety and security, and also be sensitized on such areas, and they will become ambassador of cyber safety and security in the community as well. Thank you.
Absolutely. These measures have to be kept in mind, and we all should pledge to use internet in a safer mode. Thank you. Namaskar.
Namaskar.